This time, we're going to finish up our potion sprite by shading it in and taking a look at some more of the tools available in Piskel. Now that we have our basic outline, we can finish this potion sprite by shading it in. The first thing we need to do is select some colors for the shading. I want this potion to be red, and we need to select a primary color and a darker secondary color to give the sprite some depth. To set the primary color, click in this upper left color box. I want something red. For this, I'm going for something subtle, not too bright. Okay, that will do. Then click on the lower right color box to select the secondary color. And go for a darker and bolder red. Alright, that should do. When you're using the pen tool, you're able to use both of these colors without pressing any keys or switching between them. Just press the left mouse button for the primary color and the right mouse button for the secondary color. Also, if you make a mistake, you can use Ctrl-Z to undo. We could shade this potion in with just the pen tool, but I'd like to show you how to use the paint bucket tool. The paint bucket will fill an entire area with a color. The paint bucket tool is right under the pen tool, or just press the B shortcut. If I click inside the potion, the entire area is filled with the primary color. If I right-click, the area is filled with the secondary color. I'll go ahead and fill it with the primary color, and then we'll use the pen tool to shade in the potion with the secondary color. First, I'll press E to switch to the eraser and erase this top line here so the potion isn't filled to the very top. Press P to switch back to the pen tool. And since we're using the secondary color, right-click where you want to add shading. I like to go line by line and take it slow. If you make any mistakes, just hit Ctrl-Z. It's good to let off the mouse button often so that if you do make a mistake, you don't have to undo everything you just did. You can undo step by step, going back just as far as you need. Now, we need to grab another set of colors for the glass of the bottle. Click the primary color box and select a light blue color, but bring it over towards the white, so whitish blue. But before you click away, select the color value and copy it. Then, switch over to the secondary color picker and paste the value in. Drag the color selector down and make this shade a bit darker. And drag it towards the gray a bit. Use the primary color to color the main part of the neck and lip, and then use the darker, secondary color to shade the left side. Finally, we just need two more colors for the cork. I'll grab a tan or light brown shade. Copy the color value and paste it into the secondary color. Then, drag that down into a darker shade of brown. Just like with the other colors, we use the primary color on the right side and shade it with the darker color on the left. So, there you go. We've recreated this potion, first by creating the outline and then shading it in. You should also be comfortable with the very basics of using Piskel. Now we can start to look into some of the more advanced features of the application. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Comment, like, and share this video, and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.